Disney cruising with your spouse, really fun. Disney cruising with your spouse and your kids, really fun. Disney cruising with your spouse and your kids and your mom and your dad and your mother-in-law and your father-in-law and your grandma and your grandpa and your cousin and your aunt and your sister and your brother and your sister's kids and your brother's kids and their nanny. Is that fun? Hi, Disney Cruisers. I'm Ashley. This is my face. If you are a part of our Disney Cruiser family, then give me a big like down below so I know that you're here. If you are planning your Disney cruise or love Disney cruising, then you should also consider subscribing. Let's talk about cruising with extended family. I love that I get to talk to you guys in the comments and through emails and mail and all those good sources of communication. And a lot of you do travel with family. I've had a few of you in particular even come back to me and say that after you cruise with your extended family, that maybe you won't the next time. Even though you had a good time, you just think it would be different if they weren't all there. So I'm going to tell you today that yes, traveling with extended family on a Disney cruise is way different than if they were not there. And so I'm going to tell you why based on my experiences and common sense. The reason that I added common sense into there is because when you're planning your Disney cruise and when you're just about to go on your Disney cruise, it is so exciting. Like, that's all you can talk about. You just research the crap out of it. You're just in love with it. You tell everyone you know. They're probably sick of you talking about it. It's just an exciting time. And so you kind of like, see the situation through some rose-colored glasses. And so I think that sometimes we think that because we're on a Disney cruise ship, everything will be completely different and it won't be anything like how your family is when they get together on land. Because I think some of us think that the Disney magic is going to just like put us all in its little bubble and then everything's gonna be hunky-dory and perfect for the whole cruise, when in fact, it might not. I have had the pleasure of traveling in different circumstances with different people, and while I love traveling with different family members and friends, and in no way am I saying that it is totally horrible to travel with extended family. It's not totally horrible, it's really fun, and you'll have a lot of great memories. But it's different than if you were to just go with your immediate family or your spouse or by yourself. This is what makes it different to travel with a lot of people. Not impossible, not horrible, just why it's different. There are so many things to do on a cruise. One of the great things about cruising is that you don't have to plan before you go. You could just show up on boarding day with your required documents and get on the ship and then decide everything you want to do. Now, I do think there are some things that are beneficial during online check-in that you register for, and you can check that video out here for kind of my priorities, but you don't even have to do that. You literally will have a fantastic cruise even if you don't do that part. But because nothing is planned in advance, or very few things are planned in advance, and you don't even have the navigator until you get on the ship, you will now have your large family all seeing the activities for the first time and choosing what they want to do and when they want to do it and where they want to go. I feel like there should be some kind of like rule stated that don't always have to do everything together, but you always eat dinner together, or you always eat dinner and see the show together. When people cruise, they like cruising for different reasons. Some like to relax, some like to be go, 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 some like to eat food all the time, some like to sleep the whole time in their stateroom. Some like to watch movies, others would rather play shuffleboard all day. There's just so many different things you can do and so many different personalities that it's hard for everyone to be in one place at one time doing something that will make them all happy. Because if you also force people in your family to go do other activities that they didn't want to do, they might be poopy because they're not having fun doing the activity because they didn't like it in the first place. And they might be a little poopy because that means that because they're doing your thing right now, they're not doing the thing that they really wanted to do, and maybe the thing they really wanted to do isn't going to happen again. Excursions also come into play when you're traveling with such a large party. Some excursions have age restrictions to where the younger generations won't be able to attend, and so if the younger kids can't go, maybe their parents aren't gonna go, and then there goes your plans for a super fun, exciting day at the falls. Also something to keep in mind, what if everyone's budget is different? What if half the people can't afford to do an excursion or afford to go to Palo? I also find it to be one of those things where even though you know the other part of your family or your other part of your traveling party is doing something, and maybe everyone is doing their own thing, and that's great. Like, you've set it up to where everyone can do their own thing. You meet back at dinner and there's no issues there. But still in the back of my mind, I'm always thinking, well, what are they doing? You know, are they upset we're not with them, or should we be with them? Like, are they upset they're not with us? What if they didn't want to have any kids around them right now, and we walk into an activity that they're at and my kids want to go over and bombard them and distract them from having fun at the activity they wanted to do without without my kids involved. Always in the back of your brain, you're always thinking like, what's everyone else doing? Where are they? Where do I have to be next? What can I do next to make sure that everyone is having fun and getting along? So I always feel like I'm not totally relaxed. I don't want this video to sound negative because it's not negative, it's just different. Traveling with a big group is fun. You get big tables at dinner. You can take up a whole row in the movie theater. You can have lots of people to ride the aqueduct and the slides with. You can rent a cabana at Castaway and it'll be a lot cheaper. If you have two or more staterooms and they're all right next to each other and they're veranda rooms, they'll open up the partitions in between the verandas and you guys can have like one huge long deck. The cast members will recognize you more because you travel in a large party. When you play bingo, there's more of a chance that someone you know will win, or trivia for that matter. There are a lot of positives to traveling with an extended family. And I do recommend doing it, you just need to know your expectations before going into it and realize that how you guys act as a family on land is how you're going to act as a family on a ship. The Disney bubble can only extend so much before it pops. Toodaloo, my fellow Disney cruisers.